ActiveReportsJS installation includes the cross-platform Standalone Designer application that allows developers to design report templates. The report creation process starts with data binding. ActiveReportsJS supports JSON data sources such as REST, GraphQL, and OData APIs. A data source typically refers to the root endpoint of an API. If the endpoint is protected with authentication, the data source configuration might include HTTP headers that convey credentials. A data set refers to a path that combines with the parent data source's endpoint and produces the full URL for requesting the data. The JSON path sets the pattern to select repeated nodes from the retrieved data. Once a data set is validated, its fields are displayed on the data panel. It is now possible to quickly create a tabular report by dragging and dropping the whole dataset or a subset of fields into a report body. A table visualizes a set of fields and columns, and each data record is displayed in a row. Columns and rows expose a rich set of formatting options. Report templates in ActiveReportsJS are saved in JSON format. Once the report design is complete, the template can be saved into the public folder of a React application. ActiveReportsJS provides NPM packages for popular front-end frameworks, including React. These packages can be installed using NPM or Yarn. The Grape City Active Reports React package includes the React Report Viewer component that exposes various properties that allow you to load reports, handle events, and control the visual appearance of the viewer. ActiveReportsJS provides several built-in themes for the viewer component and allows creating custom themes to accommodate the style of a hosting application. When the application runs, the Report Viewer component displays the report output, allows navigating pages, export to PDF, HTML, or XLSX formats, or printing.